Please, let's start with, give us an overview, Filipino casualties or Filipinos who are injured?
As for Filipinos, casualties, we still have unconfirmed reports. So it may be very difficult for me to give specifics. But as for Filipinos under our care, the DMW and the DFA, our welfare officers have been doing their rounds in hotels and hospitals. And we're glad to report that two of wounded Filipinos are now recovering.
Okay. All right. Now, when I interviewed the DFA yesterday, Undersecretary De Vega said there were 10 Filipinos unaccounted for. Is this still the case?
The number now has gone down to seven unaccounted for. And we assure you that DMW, GFA, and OWA are being helped by the IDF in locating our Filipino overseas workers.
Okay, so what is the priority of OWA at this point? Is it repatriation, or are you asking Filipinos to stay put? What's the order?
For repatriation, this will happen only with full clearance from the government of Israel and a full go signal from the Department of Foreign Affairs. But as of now, that may not be the immediate solution, as the exchange of fire may prevent us from doing so, and it may put our OFWs more in danger. But again, rest assured, if repatriation will proceed, OWA will be more than ready to conduct repatriation services.
Okay. Now, you've been OWA administrator for many years now, and I interviewed you years ago. This is not the first time, but although this is maybe in recent years the worst, but this isn't the first time the OWA and our OFWs have faced something like this, right? This kind of challenge. What was it like before in 2014? Balikan natin yun.
In 2014, I remember very well situations ng ating mga kababayan in Israel. They have a very high trust sa government of Israel and how they are protected. So when we sent buses there in 2014, nobody boarded the buses. They are more interested in looking for areas where they can find safety. And as soon as things go back to normal, they will just go back to Israel. But it's a little bit different now. Mas mabigat ngayon ang palitan ng putukan. But as I've said, this is not the first time that OWA and other agencies will be facing such crisis. And probably, and perhaps this experience that we have can bring some comfort to our kababayans that we can handle this and we will not stop at any point monitoring the situation of our OFWs. And we will be ready as soon as repatriation will be given a go signal.
Okay. And Arnel, most of our OFWs in Israel are caregivers. Is this correct? So at this point in time, where are they? Kasama ba nila amo nila or nasa embahada ba?
Ang mas critical nating point of concern ay yung mga nasa Gaza eh. Diyan kasi medyo will be very, very challenging kung how we can penetrate that area, and because that's not part of Israel anymore. And we have about 200 OFWs in Gaza Strip and about 137 in the Gaza area. And most of these Filipinos are married to Palestinians and Palestinians. Yun naman 200 ay mga OFW. So yan ang mas critical, Karen. Diyan tayo nakapokus as kung paano natin sila ilalabas.
Okay. But good that you talked about this. So 150, the DFA said this, are married to Palestinians, those who live in Gaza. But there are 200 OFWs working in Gaza. So yan, are they asking to be repatriated?
So far, we've received about 10 requests for repatriation. And binabantayan lang among natin yan. And as of now, again, we're in full coordination with the DFA as to our plan for movements of our Filipinos.
Oh, because right now the latest is the shelling of Israel when it comes to the shelling in Gaza by the Israeli Defense Department has been extreme. So do you receive updated reports on the status of our Filipino workers there?
As of now, we have not been receiving specific situations in Gaza, but karamihan, most of the structures in these areas have bunker shelters, ilalim na kanila mga bahay and community shelters. That will be a lot of help to protect our OFWs.
Okay, now when it comes to Israel, how many Filipinos do we have working in the southern part of Israel? That's where near Gaza is, but apparently the shelling has reached Tel Aviv based on the report from Pia Gutierrez. And that's central Israel already.
Yeah, that's quite far from Gaza already. All in all, kabuuan ng Israel, we have about 26,000 all over Israel. Specifically in the south, I guess that would be a good number to give you, yung ating pong 200 OFWs and 137. But yung, as I've said, we're nakabantay lamang kami at all contingency plans are in place. We're just waiting for go signal.
Oh, and at this point, the role of OWA, for example, clearly when it comes to funding, financial support, these are given to Filipinos when they already arrive in the country.
Yes.
Tama, no? So, tulong ang ibinibigay ng OWA?
Are you talking about when they come home?
No, right now that they're still there. Clearly not yet financial support, right?
Yes.
But still in their homes. And you're right, every building, every home has a bomb shelter.
Yes. So for now, we can assure our kababayan, the mga OFW, nakabantay po tayo. Nakabantay. Mm-hmm. And ang medyo unique dito sa sitwasyon in Israel, ang mismong IDF or the Israeli Defense Force, kasama natin. So in fact, sa yung karamihan ng ating na-secure ng mga Filipinos, mga IDF ang kumuha sa kanila. So nakikipagtulungan talaga. Yes. So yun ang kakaiba dito. Kasi sila ang kumukuha. Kasi sila lang ang makakapasok doon sa area. So we have the full cooperation and support of the IDF when it comes to securing our kababayans in Israel.
And Arnel, are there Filipinos who are being held hostage by Hamas right now? Because there are American citizens that are being held hostage.
Yeah, we got reports na meron, no? But again, as I said, we're very, very cautious na makapagbigay ng mga ganyan detalye unless it's really verified and confirmed.
So you did get reports, meaning the government has gotten reports. There are possibly Filipinos who are held hostage.
Possibly.
Possibly. Identities.
Wala pa. Katulad nung nag-a-appeal lang ako sa ating mga kababayan. Ano, initially, bago pa lumaki itong situation sa Israel, meron kaagad ang mga binanggit na agro students who were... we found out that's a false report. And the other videos na kumakalat, na verify namin na hindi rin eh. So I'm appealing to our sa ating mga kababayan na two things. Every transmission that they make can put their lives in danger because of the technology that they can be traced and it can put their lives in jeopardy. Second, it can instill unnecessary fear sa ating mga kababayan dito, no? Kaya hinihiling namin pagkatiwalaan ang kanilang pamana. This is a working government and as you can see that kami, tawagan nyo lang, we're always available, completely dedicated to monitoring the situation in Israel.
Okay, my last question is, so that's clear, the reports of the supposed agricultural students in the southern part, hindi totoo yon.
Wala
agricultural students.
Oh. na nakidnap, wala po yung agro. Yung unang-unang mga lumabas, wala naman po.
Pero may agricultural students.
Yeah, yeah. Oo.
And are they there safe now?
Meron doon mga agricultural students, but they were not kidnapped.
Oh, okay. Thank you for clarifying that. I know I'm happy that you joined us on Head Start. You have to run to Malacañang now. But what is your agenda? Can you give us a briefing? President Marcos Jr. wants to see you. What are you expecting?
I'm very sure we will be asked as to the course of action that we will be taking. And we will assure the president that with the experience of OWA, OWA has been existing for 41 years, and this is the first crisis that we'll be facing. We will bring him the confidence that we can handle this in cooperation, of course, with the Department of Foreign Affairs and the DMW. Mm-hmm. Yung aping pong karanasan, mailalatag po natin at makakapagbigay sa ating mga kababayan ng pakiramdam ng pangangalaga. That is what we promise.
Huling tanong na lang ito, Chair, no? Unang-una, the airport is closed. So technically, if repatriation is needed, is it right to say it cannot be by air? It has to be by land? I mean, am I right here in thinking this?
Our post in Tel Aviv, ang advisory lang nila ay i-postpone lahat ng flights to Israel. Pero we have not yet confirmed if the airports are closed. Not yet. So meron lang advisory na wag nang pumunta ng Israel.
Okay. On that note, I want to thank you so much for joining me today, OWA Administrator Arnel Ignacio. I hope you can update us. Thank you
so
much.
I will. Thank you very much, Karen.
All right. You take care.